If it's new and you can eat it, Sam's found it. He's the food dude.
Powered by State Farm.
The folks at Goldfish have partnered with Dunkin' Donuts, or Dunkin', excuse me.
Okay.
Next month, they're going to release Goldfish Dunkin' Pumpkin Spice Grahams.
Okay.
Took me a minute to figure. Okay. I got it.
Little fishy graham crackers that taste like pumpkin spice.
Okay.
Next month.
Got it. Just what we need.
Yeah.
And it also, sounds delicious to me.
It's okay. Yeah.
Also, too, this isn't food, new food, but McDonald's has partnered with Pokemon. The new, it's like they just today.
Wait, Pokemon things in Happy Meals?
Yes.
Oh, my gosh. But the adult children of the world are going to be
no
all
toys.
Over the place.
It's going to be cards, which is what they need.
Yeah.
A coin.
Yeah.
And some little gadget that does something for playing battles or something.
Our Taylor, who is 21 now, loves Pokemon.
Well,
and will have to have that Happy Meal.
She needs to run out and get it because it's through September 6th or until supplies last.
No kidding.
Chick-fil-A testing out new chorizo cheddar egg bites. Which I thought was unusual because they usually deal in chicken.
It's all chicken.
Yeah. Well, these are chorizo, little cheap chorizos, and some cheddar cheese and Monterey Jack cheese and eggs.
Sounds great.
And it's a little bake. So you get like four or six with an order.
That's the thing.
Yeah.
It's like a low carb. It's a keto almost thing.
Egg bites.
Yeah. Egg bites.
They're trying it out in a handful of cities starting next week. If it works out, we all get to try it.
Okay.
Hey, back to pumpkin spice. Thomas, the folks that make the English muffins and bagels.
Yes.
They're on the shelves now, the pumpkin spice versions of those two.
Of English muffins?
Yeah.
Really?
Pumpkin spice.
Yeah. Okay.
Pumpkin English muffins.
Yeah.
Miller High Life, they've released a new ice cream. It's called the Dive Bar.
That's funny.
You get it?
Bar? Yeah.
Got it? Oh, it's a bar. It's in bar form.
Yeah.
Okay.
Now, Jody just got it.
What is it?
It's got a peanut swirl. It's a vanilla ice cream, and it's got 5% alcohol by volume, so it does have beer in it.
Wow.
I don't know how they do that. Peanut swirl in honor of Dive Bar snacks.
Uh-huh.
They thought this
peanuts
one out.
Peanuts on the bar. That's cool.
It's got a hint of tobacco smoke flavor. Gooey caramel swirl intended to mimic the distinctly sticky dive bar floor feeling.
Ew.
And some kind of carbonated candy sprinkles that remind you of the fizziness.
Sounds fun. I wonder if you're going to taste the beer or it's just there.
What's the point unless you taste the beer?
I will try it, guys.
Coming up with Murphy, Sam, and Jody.
Jody has your first Hollywood Outsider at 6:20.
Coming up next, though, like Tom Holland, how to tell if you need a social media break.
Keep the Wow Wednesday. That's today. It's Jody's personal motto, and you can share your Keep the Wow moment with us, 877-310-4MSJ, or send it to us on our socials, Facebook, Instagram, Twitter.
You guys ready for, speaking of socials, how to tell if you need a social media break, just like Tom Holland just took, a famous person. He plays
Spider-Man.
So funny, but he just felt like he cannot see any more stuff about himself. He was starting to feel bad. I mean, look, he's in a different sort of ballpark and situation because he's famous.
Yeah.
Man, you have to have thicker skin than ever to be famous in a social media world. But we all, you know, have to have thick. If you're going to go online, you need to know that it's a weird place. It's a weird playground.
Even having age on your side, you still, it's hard. There are times when I'm on Twitter or Facebook and it's like, I just need to shut this off.
Right, because it's the way it's making you feel.
Because it's like, this is nonsense.
I've always said from the beginning, when we first started to talk about this, guys, that you have to learn how to self-regulate anything. It's your life. It's your time. Spend it wisely. We only get so much time.
Mm-hmm.
So how to tell if you need a social media break. These are some big clues. If you start scrolling without realizing it, if it's just habit.
Oh, you mean like it's a quiet moment, pick up the phone and start scrolling?
Right.
Yeah. I see that a lot. You ever get in an elevator with somebody and all of a sudden, boom, that's the first thing they do.
They're filling their time with it. And you don't know what they're looking at. They could be looking at work email, or they could be looking at, you know, what time am I supposed to pick up my kids? So you don't
judge. Yeah, you're right. Could be a calendar. Yeah.
But often if you're scrolling social, then you're allowing things to... You're allowing stuff into your head and heart that maybe don't need to be there.
Yes.
Here's one for you, Sam. If you notice that you get annoyed with everything you see.
and that's it.
Mm-hmm.
It's just there's so much anger and hate and
just
on
nonsense.
It's just like, please.
Yeah, you get annoyed enough in person, you don't really
I don't need to be virtually annoyed.
If it's not fun anymore for you, if you're not laughing at it, you know, if you don't go, oh, look what she's doing, my friend, let me say hello. If it's not fun, then maybe you shouldn't spend your time on it.
Or like on Facebook, for me, it takes a while scrolling to find something I want to read because there's so much negative on it.
Then maybe you should take a walk, like Tom Holland.
Who are you to tell me to take a walk?
Coming up with Murphy, Sam, and Jody.
Jody has your first Hollywood Outsider.
Here's what's trending. Jody's Hollywood Outsider.
Brought to you by Lowe's.
It's been a while since we talked about Alec Baldwin because he has been in such a bad place professionally and probably personally since the movie Rust shut down and will not happen now because of his cinematographer, his friend, Helena Hutchinson. Hutchins was her name, rather. She passed away after, you know, that gun went off was holding.
Yeah, prop. It was prop gun, but it had an actual live round in it. Yeah.
The director was injured, and there's, you know, the prosecutors still have to decide whether they're going to file charges or not. But know this, the New Mexico medical investigator has ruled that shooting on the set was accidental. It was an accident. That Alec was rehearsing a scene, and he, you know, put the hammer down on the gun, and it wasn't supposed to happen that way. He was just as surprised as everybody else on the set of the movie. So, I mean, that's definitely in his favor, but that's a medical investigator. I would think that the courts would look at that, right, and give it
some weight.
Yeah, but
like you said, it's a medical investigator, not a police officer, actual.
But don't you take medical records into account in courtrooms?
Well, I mean, there are other forensics that they can do on, you know, bullets and stuff like that. Yeah. And,
right.
You know,
do any of us, though, really think that Alec Baldwin, at this stage of his career, he meant to do anything like this?
No way. I don't think so at all.
So that's the update on the movie that won't be made now. We love to hear from you, so give us a call anytime, 877-310-4MSJ, or online.
Social media connect.
Okay, so from our Facebook page, I shared with everybody a picture of, I was throwing some shoes and a skirt into a suitcase, and I said, hey, help me pick out these strappy heels. Which pair should I wear? I have a lot of heels in my closet because I love them.
Me too.
And I noticed that the picture that you posted is not the same pair of shoes that you walked in the living room and showed me.
I'm sorry. I have a lot of high heels.
Yeah, I know you do.
Okay, so I want to say for everybody who, I'll get to that, Murphy, why I put the other heels on for you. okay, so everybody said the ankle strap ones. They're both strappy heels.
Oh, yeah,
heels.
I was going to say the one with the ankle bracelet on.
Is that the one you liked?
Yeah.
It's not an ankle bracelet. It's a strap.
Whatever.
Everybody likes the strap. Why do you, Sam, like the strap?
There's more to it.
It's prettier. It's a prettier shoe, yeah?
Hey, whatever. I just think there's more to it.
Andrea says it elongates the calf muscle. Andrea,
that's what I meant.
I never thought of that, but that's cool. So thank you. I'm wearing I put it on with the skirt that I'd planned to wear, my pencil skirt, which is a favorite skirt. Ladies, know, it's a favorite kind of skirt for me anyway, my body style or whatever type. Tammy says ankle strap. Angela, ankle strap, but mostly whatever's most comfortable. So I put those shoes on with the skirt thinking I'm all good. I'll top it with a nice little blouse and it's a cocktail event. Well, I texted my friend about this event. I'm just making sure that I'm not overdoing it. I put those other shoes on for you, Murph. Higher ones.
Yeah. Now that was interesting with Interesting with the halter top and Daisy Dukes.
Yeah. Oh, right. I don't have that.
Some kind of cocktail party.
Let everybody know. That's a joke. Yeah. I don't have that or wear that around the house.
Of course not. Yeah. Maybe you should.
Yeah. No, should never wear heels with Daisy Dukes and a halter.
Listen. I put on the other pair thinking that the other pair were higher and better and more fun anyway, but it's not even a cocktail event. I thought it was a cocktail. I'm so glad I'm not showing up as the most dressed up person. So I'm not even going to wear the pencil skirt now. I'm just going to wear, you know, nice pants with heels and a nice top.
Business casual?
It's business casual. So I can't go all out anyway. So ankle strap it might be still, but not with the skirt. So everybody's happy? So,
yeah. How many pairs of shoes are you packing for this one night?
One pair one night. Three pair for the trip.
Uh-huh.
Coming up next.
Sam's got music news powered by Capital One.
Mariah has stirred up a hornet's nest, a holiday hornet's nest, and it's only August.
Sam's music news.
Mariah Carey is trying to trademark, get this,
I know,
Queen
this.
Of Christmas.
I don't want a lot for
Really?
I don't think that. Okay, never mind. I'm not going to say it.
No, she can't. It's just
you can't
that's
do
one of those
that.
Things you just can't do. And she's started,
Mariah.
You know, she's got a couple of artists worked up, including Darlene Love, of course, who we know for this song. And she said, Darlene Love says, you just can't do that. And she says, in fact, if you do, it should be me, because I went on David Letterman in 1986 straight through to 2014. Every year, David Letterman had her on to sing this song at Christmas and called her the Queen of Christmas.
It's a holiday.
Oh, did he really?
Yeah.
You don't get to trademark yourself something of it.
And
let's think about the origins of the holiday. Be careful, Mariah.
Yeah, and it's not just that she wants to be called that and trademark that. She wants to be able to use it on clothing, liquor products, masks, dog collars, you name everything.
Right, okay.
I mean, it's enough that that song plays constantly during the holidays everywhere, and everybody loves it,
yeah.
And everybody eats it up.
Yeah.
Everybody can't wait for it.
Yeah.
She already won.
Just be happy with what you got is what you're saying.
That's what I'm thinking.
Right. Okay, Adele on the cover of Elle this week, and not only does she talk about her fiancé boyfriend, but she talks about canceling the show in Vegas.
Oh, my God, I can't believe it.
She said it was the worst moment in her career, and she actually lays out how it happened. It was the night before she canceled.
Yeah.
She said she went out in for a dress rehearsal. And she said she realized there was just no, these are her words, no soul in the show. The setup wasn't right, disconnected from the audience, and it lacked intimacy.
Good for her for sticking with her gun.
It was hard, and she went into hiding after, but she pulled the plug because it wasn't what she wanted.
Sure, good for her.
And she said she kind of took inspiration from the fireplace in her living room and the mantle for when she comes back in November. Her set's kind of going to look like that, it says.
Nice.
Oh, cool.
I know she's madly in love with her boyfriend.
Yes. And Garth Brooks is building a police station in Nashville.
'Cause I got friends.
Right next to his bar, Friends in Low Places, which hasn't opened yet.
Yeah.
There's like a little alleyway, and so he's putting a substation in there.
Oh.
And taxpayers not going to have to pay for it. The city will reap the benefits, and they'll have a substation along Lower Broadway where all the honky-tonks are.
Oh, okay.
Yeah.
Clever. We always invite you to join us online. You can give us a call, but you can also email us through the website, and we get some doozies there. And this one is from Olivia. I'm not going to read it verbatim because it's super personal, but Olivia wants some advice on how to handle a disapproving mother-in-law that for no reason, every time that she sees her mother-in-law, she is picked on, she is belittled, she feels, you know.
Murphy, you want to take this one?
Well, the easy answer is don't go to her house anymore. You know?
This is a mother-in-law who comes over.
Oh!
This is a mother-in-law who
Change
comes to Olivia's house.
Yeah.
Okay, Olivia is married to the son of this woman. Okay,
yeah, I would love to know what your advice is on that because to me, if your partner is strong enough, that really should be have your partner address that with the mother-in-law because it sounds to me like it could be that the mother-in-law either she's just a mean person or she's maybe she's just protective of her son and jealous of the relationship.
Ooh.
I don't know. You know what I mean? You never know.
You are dropping some serious, when you said jealous of the relationship, you're dropping some serious, that might not be the case with Olivia, but it is probably the case where a woman comes in and becomes the woman in his life, and there's some unease.
Yeah, and the mom's just having trouble
the
letting
mom-in-law.
Go.
My advice is that when somebody acts that way, it's always a result of the way they feel. It's not something that you did.
Yeah.
It's about the way they feel, the way they treat you. That's true for everybody. But I think that if Olivia, if you don't stand up for yourself, it's not going to stop.
Yeah.
If you don't stand up, and yes, you should talk to your partner, talk to your husband about it, and have him stand with you. But it's not just a do-it-for-me situation either. You need to, even if it's in little ways, the next time she says something to you, say something back. You know, it is your house, right? She's coming to your house and
doing
this.
Well, you don't have to come here anymore if you don't like.
Probably not the best way to handle it that way. But yeah, if you're...
Yeah, that's the advice.
In other words, you just try to steer the conversation back in a polite way or what have you.
But stand up for yourself.
Yeah.
I'm always for that.
Yeah.
Sam, was your mom ever rough on any of your exes?
Only after the fact.
Oh, yeah, I bet.
I knew that was not right for you.
Thank you, Olivia. Reach out to us anytime, murphysamandjody.com.
Coming up with Murphy, Sam, and Jody.
Jody has another Hollywood Outsider at 7:20.
Coming up next, though, baby names that get changed the most. Maybe think about these on the way. When you decide to name a child, it's something you really need to think about. This, and I hope that you do give a lot of thought. Sometimes you'll be not even pregnant yet and know what you want to name a child, and I think that's beautiful.
Yeah.
But if you're giving it a lot of thought right now, listen up.
I think you should also vocalize it. Once you come up with a name,
yes,
say it.
Say all
three. Get your spouse to say it. Everybody does, just say it.
Just in case.
To see how it feels.
Yeah. Just to make sure that there's nothing, no innuendo kind of joke or anything that would come because of the way it's said.
Of course you need to say it.
I see what you're saying. An unintended nickname or something like that.
Oh, yeah.
Anything they'd be teased for on the playground.
Yeah.
Initials that don't work out.
Exactly.
Oh.
Think of three or four letter words you don't want the initials to be. Yeah, you do need to think it through.
Yeah, my initials, STN. If I put a couple A's in there, I'm Satan.
There are no A's in it.
I know.
Okay. Santa. It could be Santa, too.
Could be.
I want to say this before I give you the names that get changed most often. Like, kids don't grow up and don't like these and change them. I'll tell you a few of them. But also say the name a lot and make sure that you like it.
Mm-hmm.
Because you're going to be saying it a lot.
Yeah.
You're going to say that kid's name constantly.
And the variations of the name.
Yes. You need to like the name. All right, names that get changed a lot. This is according to the Social Security Administration, that kids grow up and change these names, and it makes me sad because these are all good names. Isaac.
Yeah, that's a great name.
Chloe. I almost named Phoebe Chloe instead of Phoebe.
That's a beautiful name.
I love it. It's an older name, but I love it.
Yeah. Do they give reasons why those names?
I mean, every person has their own reasons.
Isaac, because you're the bartender on the Love Boat?
I don't think so. See, I wouldn't have thought that.
You know, I mean, it could be. You never know what the reason is. Is there a relative that they don't care for that's also got that name, or where you got the namesake from?
Elliot gets changed a lot. And I have a cousin, Elliot, and he's the sweetest boy.
E.T. Yeah.
Maybe it's an E.T. thing.
Elliot.
Connor gets changed. Here's one of the most beautiful female names ever, and it gets changed. Isabella.
Mm. Oh, God, I love that
and
name.
And Sophia. These names are beautiful. Eye of the beholder, though, not about beauty, but just about, you know, it's how people see themselves.
Yeah.
But just know, you're taking a chance. Whatever you name a kid, they may not like it. You are taking that chance regardless. Good luck.
Here's what's trending. Jody's Hollywood Outsider.
Brought to you by Lowe's.
Fans of the show Cobra Kai on Netflix, if you're a mad super fan, you probably already saw this, that Netflix released the full season 5 trailer yesterday. I only watched it a couple of times.
All we gotta do is get our hands dirty. If you continue down this path, nothing in your life will ever be the same again.
You can tell. It's a trailer for the whole season. It is so action-packed. It's like a little mini movie. And when we say action-packed, it's not just Johnny and you know, Danielson like kicking at each other. It's all these students and
it
all these kids.
It looks like they're united against somebody.
They are. You didn't know that? Oh, that's right. You don't watch it.
No.
It's such a great, fun show. When it's on, I can't wait for the next episode. I'll binge that so hard like it's my job. So Cobra Kai Season 5 on Netflix premieres September 9th, which is right around the corner.
Mm-hmm.
Super excited. Also, if you are a fan of Joanna Gaines, I've got news.
With this particular house, the living room was pretty tight and the seating options.
Not Chip News, just Joanna.
Just Joanna. She's so lovely. She has written a memoir, her life story. She shared that she started journaling and writing things down and realized she was writing a story, her story. And so she learned a lot about herself. And she wants to share her life story. The Stories We Tell is what it's called. Available in bookstores November 8th.
Coming up with Murphy, Sam, and Jody.
A little show and tell from Murphy on the way to keep you safe in the hotel rooms.
Recently, when I went on what Jody calls my man retreat, I realized something that I need to do next time, and I want to share it because I think it would help anybody who's traveling, especially traveling alone. And, you know, and Jody, you're about to go on a trip by yourself, too.
Mm-hmm.
You might want to consider these.
Mm.
They're little things you can carry with you that are security devices for your hotel room or an Airbnb or whatever.
Yeah.
And so I've got.
Can I just preface this?
20 seconds in.
Sam, and he showed these to me last night right before going to bed.
Yeah.
Which is not the right time. Like, I was so tired. So hit me again with them.
So they're and everyone four, else. Yeah. And so the first two are totally affordable and probably would be the ones I would lean towards. I'll save my favorite one, though, for last.
Oh, goody.
So the first one is, this is $12 deal from, it's called Lewis and Clark, and they do travel accessories.
Yeah.
And so when you pull this thing out of the back of it, it's a tiny little thing that hangs on the door frame. So if you're not watching this on YouTube, you can follow along anyway. There are two little electrodes that you stick between the door frame and the wall or between windows or whatever, and if something gets opened, it goes off.
Okay.
It's also nice to hear that right before you go to bed.
Yeah.
Okay.
So the second one, which is only $9, is a doorstop alarm. I like this one. They've got a couple of different models.
Hold and your so ears.
All you have to do is wedge this, you know, in front of whatever door it is, and as soon as somebody opens the door. Now, the problem with this one is
There's a lot of problems with it.
It keeps going until you turn it off.
Yeah.
It is really loud and would probably scare you and the person.
So you can use both of those together?
If you want to get kicked out of the hotel.
So,
I probably should have done this one first because this really is my true favorite because there are no batteries. It's very easy. It's called Adalock.
Is that a bottle opener?
It looks like a bottle opener, but all you do, you need no tools needed. You open the door of whatever the room is. You stick this little thing in the receiving part.
Yeah.
And then when the door closes, you hang the little red knob on the side.
You've added a lock. You get it? Adalock.
Yeah, it's called Adalock. And it's anybody can use this. It's totally portable, no batteries or anything. And you can't open the door with that thing.
This one doesn't make a noise.
No, no noise, and it keeps it locked. And I've tried it on a couple of different doors. It works very well.
But Jody keeps showing up.
So, all right, so those are the first three.
Maybe not anymore.
Can I show you the fourth one?
Yeah.
No.
All right, that's coming up after 8.
Three things you need to know today.
Number one, the World Health Organization says, help us give monkeypox a new name. They're taking suggestions. They're saying monkeypox is too stigmatizing, has actually led to wait. It's actually led to recent attacks on monkeys in parts of the world. Brazil is one of them. The virus did originally come from monkeys, but, you know, it doesn't. Does that matter?
You know,
now that we call it monkeypox and we've called it this for this long, I think it's going to be hard to change it.
Who cares? It's like swine flu. We didn't go after pigs.
I know.
Chicken pox. We didn't kill chickens.
World Health Organization is asking. Number two.
Oh, Lord.
There's a class action lawsuit that's been filed against Kia and Hyundai. Car owners are claiming that these cars are too easy to steal, and they are stolen a ton.
Oh.
Thefts. In major cities, these kinds of cars, 700% up since last year. Hmm. Apparently, they were built without engine immobilizers. That means nothing to me, but they're easy to start without a key.
Didn't know that.
So if you have a Hyundai or a Kia, you're urged right now until the manufacturers can do something, you're urged to purchase a steering wheel lock.
That would include me.
Ooh, look out. And number three, it's National Thrift Shop Day. Since the pandemic and because of inflation, they're more popular than ever with millennials and Gen Zers, especially biggest fans of thrift shops. And everybody's hoping to find like a cute little painting for $10 that ends up being worth millions.
Three things to know today.
Catch up on anything you might have missed with the Murphy, Sam, and Jody podcast. School's back in session for a lot of kids, not all kids yet. But, you know, if your schedule's a little thrown off, that's an easy way to catch up with things for free here. And as promised, I got the follow-up for you on what we were talking about last hour. You know, there's some security travel things that I'm recommending. Jody and Sam think they're security junk.
Wait. Sam probably likes them.
But,
right?
No, it's junk.
It's useful junk because it's only junk because it's cheap. And if you're traveling alone, there are, you know, there are men and women.
And if that
there
makes
a lot
you
of women
nervous.
Especially will, yeah, if you're nervous traveling by yourself, these are things that will help.
I'm just curious. Okay, you gave us three last hour and you're going to get your favorite one coming up in a, you know, right after this. But what provoked you to order these?
Right. Well, I actually only ordered two after the fact. If I'm going to do a retreat again, I realize I was way out in the middle of the woods.
Uh-huh.
This Airbnb was not the most securely locked place in the world. and where I was sleeping.
Wonky
and
French
and
doors.
And I sleep really, really hard. So, yeah. I had trouble sleeping, you know, because, so that's why, too. And then I realized, hey, you know, why not share this with everybody else? I found a few more online and figured I would just, like, test them all out. The one that I really like is by Attalock, which has been around for a while. It doesn't require any tools. It's basically a wedge, for lack of a better term, that you'll see that the door just can't be open, and you don't need any tools to put it in, and you're set. My favorite is a piece of junk, though.
Wait, Sam, I think that this Sam might like this one. I know.
You know how he likes junk.
I know Sam's going to love this one, actually.
This one is a portable motion sensor.
Oh.
It's like a little robot.
Yeah, you can set it to chime. You can set it to alert with a piercing sound. You can make
a piercing sound.
You've been reading the brochure.
Let me show you what it does. And so,
attention, please.
Okay, so that's
monitoring.
Just
right.
It's
right.
Working.
Yeah, it's working. Yeah.
Hello, welcome.
So if you all right. If you get up to go to the bathroom in the hotel in the middle of the night,
and you forget that you had it there, you're going to scare yourself.
Yeah, if you walk in front of it, it's going to, you know.
There's the one to use.
Yeah, that's why I say it's junk.
Those people in that room have a dog.
Really? Sounds like a really small dog.
So how much did all this junk set you back?
Oh, that one's $21.
I have no words.
I can't get it to stop.
Monitoring.
Exactly!
Coming up with Murphy, Sam, and Jody.
Attention, please.
Okay.
Turn it off!
Keep the Wild Wednesday. I'm going to hear from you next. Abby, 877-310-4MSJ. Join us anytime, 877-310-4MSJ.
Good morning, Abby.
Good morning. I was calling on the Keep the Wow segment.
Yes. You have one?
Yes. So today was the first day of school for my girls in elementary school. Mm. And as a mom, I got everybody dressed and looking nice and out of the house on time.
Woo-hoo.
So we're starting the school year off.
Yes.
Sane.
Right. And so afterward, did you go home and just chillax? Probably not.
I wish. I am on my way to work, but I'm on my way to work on time.
Yay. It's a
which
lot.
Which is a good mom high five for the first day.
We focus so much on the kids and making sure they have everything they need and they're in the right clothing and the right mindset and the right binders and all of that. But there is a whole other world of the mom, the parents.
Yes.
And that new routine, you're ready for it, but there's a low-level anxiety, right?
Oh, my gosh. Yes. It was a lot of prep work last night, but, I mean, there's been years that even with the prep work, it's just a madhouse, and it all falls to pieces. But this year started off good, so
great.
I've got my coffee, and I'm on my way to work, and my girls are, they look decent.
So you did. That's a wow.
Everybody's on time.
It's a lot. So that is a wow. Keep it. That's a victory to start your day.
Yes.
And did you get the first day of school?
Thank you very much.
Did you get the first day of school pictures?
I sure did.
Yay.
Awesome.
I'm jealous.
I sure did. They're in focus and everything.
It is a wow.
thank you, Abby, for the call.
The thing about it is, as you get older and you've done it more and more, you understand it doesn't have to be perfect.
Right.
But it's when you're, they're in first grade and you want to get all that right and you want things to be like the fairy tale that you thought parenthood was going to be. And when it's actually the roller coaster that it is, it's kind of a storm every day.
Oh, yeah. So at least this way, it can be done,
Yeah.
Which is why
you've
Abby
done
should
it.
Keep the wow. Yeah.
Yeah. And thank you for that, Abby. Join us anytime to let us know about your wows, the way you wow yourself. That's what it is to keep that and focus on that. So 877-310-4MSJ.
Here's what's trending. Jody's Hollywood Outsider.
Brought to you by Lowe's.
That new Princess Diana documentary on HBO and HBO Max. I saw that it landed there last week, and it's called The Princess.
Sweet, kind.
The princess has been the best thing to happen to the monarchy in centuries.
Did you get a chance to
this
see
this documentary?
It's been one of the recommended things when I pop it up, but it's like, I can't watch that.
What?
I
wanted to watch it desperately, and I've got it checked to catch it when I can. I cannot wait. Because it's told not in, you know, not with current interviews, but all archival footage from media over the years and how they followed her. And there is a ton of stuff, obviously, to put a whole documentary together. But what's interesting now is that Prince William has voiced his displeasure with it.
The whole thing? Or
no. There's one particular part of it where she did this BBC interview in 1995 where she referenced Prince Charles's relationship with Camilla.
Yeah.
And how unhappy she was. Also, during this interview, she talked about how unhappy she was being a part of the royal family. And the interview was later sort of discredited because they were like, hey, they used deception to get her to say those things. It's one of those tricky things.
Oh.
And the family felt didn't like it, and William didn't like it, and he would like for them to remove that part of it. The spokesperson for the documentary says the interview is shown briefly in context and it's a moment of historical record. Sorry, William.
Yeah.
I want to go back to Olivia's email from earlier. She was asking,
oh, the mother-in-law question,
what our advice is for, I mean, she sent it to me, but I loved what you had to say, Murphy, about maybe the mother-in-law's jealous of you. I'm thinking,
yeah, she's having an Olivia issue.
A mother-in-law issue.
No, I'm sorry. Olivia's having a mother-in-law issue, but I get the mother-in-law clearly is having an Olivia issue, too. But,
yeah, what to do about a disapproving mother-in-law that makes you feel like there's something wrong with you every time she's in your presence, in your home.
Yeah. You know, I mean, obviously it's more about the mom than it is about Olivia.
Totally.
I still think, though, that hubby needs to get
absolutely
involved in the conversation.
Absolutely. If I was in a situation where I was not being, like, at least defended a little bit by a man in that situation, I'd be like, well, I think I might need to change up. I don't know. I would feel like I needed some support.
Yeah.
If I was really being treated badly.
I never had to do that for you when my mom was alive, right?
Of course not.
Yeah,
oh,
I mean,
my God.
She was sweet to
Are you.
You
kidding me?
Yeah.
You have to know this, Murphy, though. The legend of your mom was a real thing before I met her. I had heard so much about her. Her name was Merle, and you all called her Merle. And I had heard about what a strong personality she was.
She's a very strong personality.
And
yeah.
So I was nervous that I would have some. I was nervous that she wouldn't like me, and then it would be this situation. But she was always really great. In fact, I sort of bonded with her.
Yeah.
You know what I mean?
I know you did.
She was so sweet to me. The first time that you brought me to the beach vacation, where I knew I was going to burn in 5 minutes out there with your family, she walked up to me and brought me a, this does not make Olivia feel better, I know. She walked up to me and brought me a beach cover up that had sunscreen on it, like in it.
Oh,
remember,
yeah.
Do you remember that?
I do remember that.
It
yeah.
was so sweet.
Yeah.
And I got to stay out the whole day.
But, you know, so.
Still burned, but.
So, you know, for Olivia, I guess if we knew a little bit more about what the mother-in-law is picking on.
Well, everything. I mean, I have an email on it, but I don't want to be specific about
sure,
it.
Okay.
Every little thing, clothing, you know, what you look like and all this kind of stuff. And I just want to say to you, Olivia, the more I think about it, it is always about the way the other person feels about themselves. That is about your mother-in-law. She's miserable. She's got to be.
Yeah.
Because why pick on you if you're not doing anything and you're always sort of kind of giving in and just being nice?
So should Olivia spout off to mother-in-law that?
I don't.
This isn't about me. It's about you.
No, not spout off, but stand up for yourself.
The Joe Bros are headed back to Vegas for what they're calling another residency.
They're calling it?
Well,
what does that mean?
It's kind of a... They're coming back for 3 days in November.
Oh, you know, that's a weekend.
That's not a residency to
no,
me.
No, it's not.
All the headlines I see say residency.
It's not.
They even said, we're coming back, residency.
Maybe it's the Vegas marketing team who says, call it a residency.
Yeah. So it's November 10th, 11th, and 12th. They're going to be back. They just finished in June with a five-day residency. cool thing about this, though, is like the one they did in June, every night, every set's going to be different.
Oh, that's
so
cool.
They change it up every night.
Ooh.
Yeah.
So
cool.
Maybe in this case, the residency is a couple times a year, same place over and over, same venue.
It is the same place that they were in June, Dolby Live at Park MGM.
Okay.
So maybe that.
Whoa. That's where Aerosmith was supposed to be when Jody and I
went. That's where they will be in September.
Right, exactly, when Jody and I won't be there.
I know.